Hey guys, Tiffany with another video, and yes, as you guys saw in the title, this is going to be my end of month favorites video for the month of February. I'm honestly not surprised that we're already done with February. I mean, there's not that many days in February as it is. Y'all know if they was gonna give black people a month, it was gonna be the shortest one anyway. Now, if you guys are familiar with my channel, you know that during the middle of the month, I bring you guys the current beauty favorites because I don't want my end of month favorites to be like super duper long. So if you have not already checked out that video, I'll leave a link right here and you guys can go back and look at some of the things that I was loving towards the middle portion of February. I have quite a lot. I have skincare. I have some really good like face products. Like, I just was loving so much stuff for the month of February. I felt like I was trying out a lot of stuff, so I do have some new things to show you guys as well. But no more talking, let's get started. So as always, I will start off with skincare first. Now, the first skincare item that I was loving is this Garnier Skin Active Micellar Cleansing Water. Is it micellar? Micellar? You know how like when you really don't for sure 100% know how to pronounce something, so you like Google it or you look up other videos of people talking about it, but it's like everybody pronounces it different, so then you really don't know. But y'all know what I'm talking about. This right here, you can definitely tell from how much I have left in the bottle. Like, I really love this. Now, you can use this for different things in whatever way that you choose. It does say that you can remove your makeup, cleanse your skin, and also refresh your skin. It's no rinsing and no harsh rubbing. They came out with two different ones. This one is, I believe, the oil-free one. The other one has like some type of oil in it, but because my skin is already oily, I wasn't trying to play those games. But I love this to use in the morning. I'll just put it on a cotton swab and just like clean my face off. Again, it just really refreshes my skin. Hold on, y'all, because my neighbor across the street is pregnant and she got a gang of bags and she don't need to be lifting those. I'll be right back. So for me, I just feel like anything that may be lingering over from the night before, be it like any moisturizer or anything, I just always use this to just cleanse off my face before I go in with my skincare regimen for that morning. This is one of the better ones out there. I have tried quite a few. I've tried some drugstore and I've also tried some high-end ones, and I always go back to this one, so I really do love it. The next skincare item that I've been loving is from Clinique. I also showed you guys a Clinique item in my current beauty favorites from the middle of the month, but this is the Clinique Pore Refining Solutions Correcting Serum. This is a staple product in my skincare regimen. You guys know, if you're familiar with my channel, that I suffer from pores. I know y'all looking like, Tiff, we don't see no pores, but girl, when you get up on this face, I do have issues with my pores, and I feel like my pores are a lot larger than they should be. So I've really been focusing on like targeting my pores. I love this. I've been using this for years now, but I have to kind of stop using it for a while and then I'll pick back up and use it again. But this is just really good if you have large pores and you want something that is going to correct that and help sort of close your pores up and make them not look as noticeable. But again, because I feel like my skin gets so used to it, I'll use it for a while, but then I have to stop using it and start using something else because I feel like if I use it on a consistent basis, it doesn't work as amazing as it did when I first used it. But I do really love this. I think this is one of the better pore targeted serums out there, and it's just something I will continue to repurchase. Then the final skincare item I have to show you guys is from Neutrogena. This is their new Rapid Clear Stubborn Acne Daily Leave-On Mask. Guys, this is something new that I have included in my skincare regimen. I don't use this on an everyday basis, but this works. This is a drugstore. You guys know Neutrogena. You can basically find it in Walgreens, CVS, Rite Aid, Walmart, Target, all that. But for it to be a drugstore skin item, I'm telling you, this works. My skin had broke out so bad. And I know what it was. It was a new makeup item that I was trying and it broke my face out so bad. Like, I was like, oh my God, I'm not gonna be able to film for like 3-4 weeks. I picked this up on a whim, and when I tell you, it does such an amazing job. This has benzoyl peroxide in it, which, you know, a lot of acne targeted products do have that in it. And basically what it does is it kind of like dries out the infected area. So I was applying this on my face. It's a leave-on mask, so you can wear this day or night. I would apply it on and then put my moisturizer on top, and I definitely noticed where my skin was clearing up a lot faster had I not used anything. So I will say that this definitely works. But again, the one thing that may put some people off is that it dries out your skin. So I'm combination oily and it dried out my skin. I had to make sure I used it with a moisturizer. So if you're already dry, I don't know how this would affect your skin, but I say if it's something you use in conjunction with a moisturizer, it shouldn't be that bad. But if you want your acne cleared up, pick this up. So a mascara that I have been loving and using nonstop for this month is from Wet n Wild. This is their Lash Renegade Mascara. I really love the packaging. I mean, yeah, it's kind of bulky, but I do think that it's really, really cute. And then when you open it up on the inside, it has like this ball on the end. And I feel like a lot of mascaras are doing this now where they have this little ball thing on the end that you're supposed to really use to get like every part of your lashes. I don't really care for the wand, but the formula of this mascara. Y'all know I'm a part of the Itty Bitty Lash Committee. When I say I have like no lashes at all, and this mascara gives the look of lashes. Like, I love it. I feel like I was about to sleep on this because I almost didn't pick it up. Like, Wet n Wild, no. Not when it comes to my mascaras, but this is amazing. If you are in the market for a really good mascara, just even overlook the fact that it's drugstore. If you tooting your nose up like, I'm just gonna stick with my Lancome and I'm just gonna stick with my Chanel, girl, bye. You better pick this up. This thing is amazing. I have three lippies that I was loving for the month. The first one is one of these Sephora cream lip stains. This one is in the number 40 pink tea. This is just a really, really pretty pinky mauvey nude type of color. I feel like every color I have for you guys this month has been leaning towards this type of shade, but it's really pretty. These are super, super comfortable on the lips. Sephora has introduced so many new shades, so I'm telling you, you'll be able to find something that tickles your fancy. But I have just kind of been rocking this nonstop. I've been keeping it in my car, keeping it in my purse. It's just a really, really pretty color. But the next lippy that I've been loving this month is one of the NYX Lingerie Liquid Lipsticks. This is one of the newer shades. This one is in French Made. That's what it looks like. And y'all, this color is so doggone pretty. That is it right there. I don't know how well it's gonna show up on camera, but that is it right there. This shade is so pretty. I have seen this on so many different skin tones, and I feel like it flatters all skin tones, but this has just been like one of my go-to shades. And then the final lippy is the one that I'm actually wearing today. I have been rocking this in quite a few videos. I've been rocking this like in person. My sister recently tried to steal this when I was home. Like, this lipstick is bae. This has been bae for me all February. This is one of the Urban Decay lipsticks. This one is in Strip. And I did not know that this color has been discontinued, so I was pretty bummed about it myself because I love this. But you guys were like, Tiff, we've been looking for it and it's discontinued. So I am so sad. Urban Decay, you probably don't watch my videos, but if for some reason this happens to come across your desk, please bring Strip back, because it like, I need this. I don't even want to use it anymore now that I know it's discontinued. And so many of you guys have been like, Tiff, we need a dupe for a Strip. That is Strip right there. I'm kind of looking at it. It kind of look, what up. It kind of, oh no, that one's a little bit darker. I was about to say, because wait a minute, that may be an exact dupe for it. But Strip is not a matte lipstick, and you know, the NYX Lingerie is dry down. But it is so pretty. So many of you guys have been like, Tiff, girl, if you don't find us a dupe. And I found something that is super, super close. Dominique, You've been asking for it, and I found something again that to me I feel is really close. This is one of the ColourPop lippy sticks. This is in the shade Toasty, which I don't believe is limited edition. I'm gonna be so pissed if I'm sitting here like, hey guys, I found something, and then this is limited edition as well, so I hope it's not. But you guys know how the lippy sticks look, and I'm just gonna swatch it next to Strip so you guys can see. So that is Strip and that is Toasty. And of every lipstick that I have, those two, they are super, super similar. And then finally, the palette that I have been loving this month, it's a oldie but a goodie. Is this limited edition? I gotta stop bringing y'all limited edition stuff, but I can't help what I've been loving for the month. When it comes to my favorites, like on a regular basis, tutorials, get ready with me, I try not to bring you guys limited edition stuff, but I can't help what I've been loving. The Master palette by Mario and Anastasia Beverly Hills. I picked this back up. I've been using this like, I just fell in love all over again. That is what the shades look like. And I know some people are like, that's more like a fall type of shade. Girl, you can use this year round, hush. I love the like jewel tone colors. I'm not wearing this today, although I did use Isabel as my transition shade, which is right there. But I used another Anastasia Beverly Hills palette. You guys know everything that I wear on my face is listed down below in the description box. But I love this. I've just been using this for like onesie, twosie type of looks. Just pop on a lid shade and then like blend a transition shade in the crease. I love it. I think this was limited edition. I don't think you could get your hands on it anymore. But if they ever re-release it, sometimes Macy's, Belk, sometimes they put out like more palettes that I guess they found in the back of a warehouse somewhere. But if you can ever get your hands on it, somebody brings it back out, pick it up if you haven't already, because it's so pretty. And then finally, you guys know I bring you my book of the month and my song of the month. I don't have a book of the month for you guys. I just finished up reading the I'm Judging You by Lovie Ajayi. So if you guys have not checked that out, like guys, that book is amazing. I think that was her first book, but I need her to like come out with some more books because I love that book. That book stays in my car if I just want to pick it up as I'm eating lunch and I just need something to read. Like, it's one of those books I feel like you'll never get tired of reading. You'll always find something in there to make you laugh or something you missed like beforehand. So that definitely has been my book for the month of February, because I picked it up in January, but I didn't completely get through it. But I've actually finished it and I love it. But my song of the month, we about to get a little ratchet.
You know, so we really never had no old money. We got a whole lot of new money though. If you're metro, I don't trust you. I'm gonna shoot you. Hey, raindrop, drop top, smoking, no cooking the hot pot. Cooking, no, you're pushing it, dot. Cooking the poop in the crock pot. Came from nothing to something. Hey, I don't trust nobody, grip the trigger, nobody. Call up the gang and they come and get gang. Cry me a river, give you a tissue. Hey, it's bad and bullshit, bad. Cooking up with a Uzi. Bah. My niggas are savage, ruthless. We got thudders and 100 rounds too. God. My it's bad and bullshit, bad. Cooking up with a Uzi.
I know, and y'all know, my parents are preachers, so Ma, I know you're watching. Jesus is not through with me yet. That song gets you hype. Like, how do you not get in the mood when Bad and Bougie comes on? I love that song. I'm not even like a Migos fan, but I love that song. That song comes on in the car. I'm jerking. That song comes on in the grocery store. I'm embarrassing the kids because I'm popping, locking, and dropping. That song comes on in the gym. I run a little bit harder on the treadmill. Like, I love that song. Whatever. Judge not so that ye may not be judged. Oh, yes, Ma. I know my scriptures. Alright guys, so that is it for my February favorites. I know this video was probably a little long. I don't have the little timer on my screen anymore, but I just feel like this video was long, so I apologize for that. But I needed to show you guys the things that I have been loving. Definitely let me know what you guys think of the items that I showed. If you have any of them, you love them, you dislike them, all that stuff. You know I want to know down below in the comment section. As always, I have to say thank you guys so much for rocking with your girl. We are almost at 30K. I prayed about 30K, but I just didn't know that 30K would come this soon. But thank you guys so much for getting the word out. Continue to share my videos. Continue to let everybody know all about this crazy girl from Florida who just really loves beauty, and that is the reason why I do it. Without you, there would be no me, because nobody would watch. So thank you guys so much. You are definitely the real MVP. And until next time, bye YouTube.